Apple's Mac operating system version 14, MacOS Sonoma, is coming this fall, 2023, and with new updates comes change. And many people, like myself included, change isn't fun. So I'll be going over a few of the new features with MacOS Sonoma that I believe casual users, meaning non-tech, non-Apple enthusiasts, will actually care about, and hopefully this will make you update your Mac. So let's get into it. So I was gonna start off with the new slow motion screensavers hosting beautiful aerial views from all around the world, from the Grand Canyon all the way to Iceland, or even show you the new lock screen that's been updated to look exactly like the iPhone or iPad, but those things most people won't even notice. So let's start with this, widgets. Everyone knows how useful widgets can be. You probably have them placed somewhere on your phone. Being able to place widgets from your notification center to your desktop and get easy views of the weather, your calendar, your to-do list. These widgets are interactive, so you can check things off straight from your desktop without having to open up any other applications. This is something you may not even notice, and that's pretty much the whole purpose, but widgets fade into the background when clicked off onto the browser or another application. When you reselect the desktop, the widget color snaps back. Right, next, we're gonna go to transform websites into apps. So you can now create web apps from your favorite websites and place them straight onto your dock. This way, there is no need to fumble around, going to the browser, searching through your bookmarks, just to go to your favorite websites. This creates a super seamless experience and definitely one of the features that I'll be using on a regular basis. Reminders updates. I think most people have moved away from reminders onto third-party applications, just because Reminders wasn't cutting it, but these new updates might make you want to try it again. Reminders will now categorize grocery lists into things such as dairy, meats, household goods, those type of things to help you stay organized inside of the grocery store so you're not jumping from aisle to aisle. Another update is the column view, which makes it easier to visualize your task. I think this is a great way to organize projects or even tasks in different aspects of your daily routine. All right, photos. We know in photos, albums can be automatically created by people using facial recognition, but now photos will be able to recognize your cats and your dogs. This was announced as kind of a small feature, but I believe this will make a big impact on those pet lovers that are out there. You can now use dictation and the keyboard together. No one I know really uses any speech-to-text software, because honestly, it's awful, but this update might make it better. I'm lazy, so if a good quality speech-to-text comes up, I'm willing to try it. You can fluidly move from dictation to keyboard typing and just go back and forth, whatever you like, so that might be a cool feature for you to try out. Safari. So you can create profiles within Safari. This is a good way to separate your personal life from your work life. You can create as many profiles as you wish, with all their own separate history, extensions, cookies, and favorites. This is something that Google Chrome has had for a little bit now, but for those Safari users out there, this is definitely a cool feature to have, or the ones that are wishing to move over to Safari. Password sharing. So you can create groups and add accounts to share passwords with. This is a useful way for families or significant others to share streaming account usernames, logins, and other joint accounts of some sort. And you can stop getting those texts asking, what's the Netflix password again? Video conferencing. So for those of you that have done presentations inside of Zoom, you know there's some comfort that comes with sharing your screen and not having to show your face anymore. I'm not sure how many people would use this feature, but the presenter overlay feature is here. You can choose between large and small overlay and have your whole body or just your face as part of the presentation. And using this is honestly kind of confusing because you're not really sure where you're looking or where you're pointing, but it is out there and it's good. It's a good way to stay connected with your audience during your presentation. Well, that's all the features I believe will be the most useful to casual users. I will have Apple's Mac OS Sonoma overview linked in the description if you want to take a look at that and view all the updates that will be in this release. Let me know what features excites you the most in the comment section. If you enjoyed this video, leave a like, consider subscribing. Leaving super likes helps me out a lot to continue growing my production quality and I'll give you a personalized thank you through a short. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.